This is a Western Spotted Skunk. They can be found roaming the forest floors from northern Mexico through the Pacific Northwest and into parts of southwest Canada. Despite their wide range, surprisingly little is known about this mysterious species.
They are still a skunk, so they do spray. I would say I was sprayed about, so many times, 50 to 100 times throughout the course of trapping them and working them up.
That was Marie Tosa, a postdoctoral scholar in Oregon State University's College of Agricultural Sciences. She spent 2.5 years nearly nonstop researching the Western Spotted Skunk in the H.J. Andrews Experimental Forest, a 15,800-acre forest located in the Cascade Mountains, northwest of Mount Bachelor.
Western spotted skunks are playing a really key role between prey sources like primary consumers, deer mice, insects, and other small mammals. But they also get consumed by things like bobcats and barred owls and spotted owls sometimes.
Western spotted skunks are known to cover nearly 12 square miles in search of food and mates. According to Tulsa, their home range is enormous, especially when compared to the native black-tailed deer, which have a recorded home range of only a square mile.
This project was trying to figure out more about them, trying to learn about their natural history and what they do in these forests. What do they need? How do they influence the ecosystem that they're in?
Smaller than their common rivals, the striped skunk, the Western spotted skunk weighs between 10 and 28 ounces, and their length varies between 14 and 16.5 inches.
What are you doing in there, 893? You look healthy.
They rest during the day in things like snags or downed logs, burrows that other creatures have made, and this is a time for them to just rest and sleep.
Tulsa's research process began when she and her team set up trail cameras, baiting them with sardines and cat food and just about anything they believe would attract small carnivores. After identifying areas where these small carnivores were active, they set up live traps, taking time to bait them with sardines and strong lure. To make the traps more inviting, they often covered them with burlap, moss, or bark to mimic a natural hiding spot. Each morning, starting around 7 a.m., Tosa would drive out to check the some 100 traps. If she found a skunk, the team would collar it before releasing it back into the study area.
Since they're so small, we're really limited in the technology that we can use. We would want to put a GPS collar on them, but GPS collars at this point are pretty heavy still. We're in a really closed canopy forest at the H.J. Andrews that prevent that signal from getting to the satellites. So we were using radio telemetry.
Tulsa and her team tracked the skunks both day and night throughout the mountainous area of the H.J. Andrews. Over the course of her work, Tulsa estimated her and her team covered well over 12,000 miles trapping and documenting data for the project.
These animals are cruising, so we would take a truck, have an antenna out the window, and we'd be driving all over the Andrews and outside of the Andrews to figure out where they were, get one signal on them, and locate them that way.
The Western spotted skunk is not listed as endangered and is believed to be relatively common throughout its habitat range.
We thought the same thing about the Eastern spotted skunk back in the 50s and 40s, but during that time, those eastern spotted skunks declined a lot. Their populations declined by about 90% in about 10 years, and then 99% in about 40 years.
The primary threat to many species, including the Western spotted skunk, is habitat destruction. Without a clear understanding of the specific habitats these skunks rely on, effective conservation efforts are challenging to say the least.
In the West, one of the biggest disturbances on the landscape is logging. Do Western spotted skunks actually need old growth forest in order to survive and reproduce? And what we found was kind of a mixed bag. They seem to persist more in those old growth forests and mature forests, but they seem to be using a lot of those young forests as well for food resources.
Since Tulsa's study in the H.J. Andrews concluded, the forest has sustained 3 fires between 2019 and 2024. As of this recording, the latest fire consumed close to 3,500 acres.
The Holiday Farm fire in 2020, the Lookout fire in 2023, and then the most recent one, the Ore fire in 2024. And so all of those fires have subsequently come through the area. We think that the Western Spotted Skunks would be adapted to fire coming through the landscape, but we have really no idea how that affected the Western Spotted Skunks.
As fire season in the Pacific Northwest concludes, Tosa hopes her research will serve as a foundation for further studies on this species, helping to prevent the Western Spotted Skunk from facing the same challenges as the Eastern Spotted Skunk.